Hi everyone, Piet Kalemeijn here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So in today's video, I would like to show you how you can make a custom pad stack in Altium Designer. Now let's start with the basics. This is a simple pad, so how can you add, for instance, in the PCB library pad? You press P and then you can select pad or press P again. And then there's a couple of options that you have for these pads. So the standard options that you have are round, rectangular, octagonal, rounded, chamfered. So you can choose whatever type you like. And that is an easy way to have, let's say, a very simple pad in your Altium Designer, and you can start working from there. These options, I'm going to discuss these at the end of the video, but let's maybe assume that you need a very custom pad. For instance, I have a data sheet over here of an inductor. There's a very specific custom pad size that we need to integrate. How can you do that easily with Altium Designer? That's what I'm going to show you. Now, assume, of course, for a lot of components, there are already component libraries available where these pads are there, but maybe assume that you have a very specific custom requests, there's no library available, then this is how you can do that. So first of all, maybe you already have a region. How can we translate this into a custom pad? Again, same thing, you add a pad in here. Let's go maybe for a small round one. It doesn't really matter in fact what kind of pad type that you use for this, but just put your pad in here, and then it's important to select that pad and the custom region. You go right click, pad action, add selected region to custom pad, and what you see is that now your custom region has been translated into a pad. Then again, if you click it, you will have a lot of options over here that you can alter, like the top paste, top solder. This can then all be altered, but this is now seen as a pad. So you don't have one pad and then a piece of top layer that is not part of the pad anymore. It is seen as a complete pad. So this makes it really interesting. Now we started from a region. You can also start from an outline. So what I have done here is I've used this data sheet, these dimensions, to make a pad line. It is in mechanical one that I have made that drawing. So it's a piece of an arc, a couple of line segments, and that is my outline. That is one-on-one, exactly the same, let's say, as this top part of this inductor. What you can do then is, again, you place a pad inside the outline. That is, of course, important that you place it inside. You select everything, you go right click, pad actions, create custom pad from selected outline, and Altium does the magic for you. This is really nice. Now again, you have your pad just based on the outline that you have created. So this is a very simple way, if you know how to do it, how to make a custom pad stack in Altium. Now there's some more things that we can do. I just want to show you a couple of small things. Best thing, of course, is to play yourself with all the options, but this is a short overview of what is possible. So right here, I already made a rectangular pad. It's just adding a pad that I did via the standard way that we have been using before. I've made it 2 millimeters in width, 1 millimeter in height. Now, what you can select is the other shapes that we have discussed, but you can also use custom shape. Now, if you do that, you can open it up here in the properties as well. And then you can really customize the complete shape again, as we have been doing before. So you can try and, let's say, shift it out a bit, make it wider. You can add extra vertices in here by holding down Control and then clicking to try and have a very specific shape. So a lot is possible there. Now then, some other things that are interesting as well is the terminal reliefs. So standard, there's 4 terminal reliefs that are foreseen, but you can edit this as well. So how to do that? First of all, it's important that you click the relief box over here, and then you should click it here as well, so that this is really on. And you can edit these points. So what you see over here right now, this is where my terminal reliefs will be. Of course, this is a very odd shape, but it's just to show you. But you can click and add in an extra terminal relief, for instance, over here. You could add in another one over here. So this is 100% your choice where you can put the terminal reliefs. So this is interesting stuff. There's, of course, rules assigned to that. Now, if you click this, you will open up the polygon connect style. And over here, again, you can determine if it's a manual configuration, if it's 2 or 4 conductors that you're going to use, how the typical connect looks like, if it's a direct or not. Well, we need a relief, of course, because we are determining reliefs. So this can then be altered here as well, if you wish. For instance, let's increase the air gap a bit to 0.5 millimeters. And then you'll see it being translated in here again. So these are a couple of quick ways for reliefs. There's also options to change the top paste, top solder. So for instance, top solder is now with a standard rule expansion. You could make it manual, and then you can choose whatever you like to have as expansion. So it's been increased. If you want to have a tented pot, let's say, you could also check the tented box, and then there is no top solder. So a lot of options over here. I'll let you explore it by yourself. But these are the main things that I wanted to tackle. Last thing that I would like to show you is how this applies to multi-layer pots as well. So until now, we have always been working with a simple pot stack, a single layer. Now you can also use a multi-layer. So important to go ahead and select multi-layer first. If you have selected multi-layer, you'll see that the full stack becomes an option here as well. Now, the full stack will typically, of course, be all the layers that you have in your PCB layer stack. So we only have two layers right here. We only see top and a bottom layer. Now, what you see is that you can indeed change the custom shape of these two layers separately from each other. Depends a bit on your application if it is of real practical use, but let me quickly show you. So you can edit the shape over here. So for instance, we draw in that bottom layer a bit, and then you have a difference between your top and your bottom layer, the red and the blue lines that you see over here. In the 3D view, you see that this has happened here as well. You could also, for instance, maybe expand one part. So again, if you would go and make this larger than the other side, you'll see that indeed as well in 3D, this is now changed. So you can do that with a full stack, a bit depending of when you might need that. So this wraps up this video about custom pad stack design. I hope this was interesting for you. Looking forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye bye.